I got involved in the industry in the early 90s, and there were still pretty much bleeps and bloops, you know?
It's interesting. From a career standpoint, you know, I've been called the person who's helped to change video game music, because when a lot of people thought of video game music, they thought of bleeps and bloops, right? So being associated with someone who's changed an entire genre of music is pretty cool.
You know, when I first started doing video game music in the, you know, late 80s, early 90s, it was bleeps and bloops. And so I would do this real music, and people were so used to hearing bleeps and bloops in video games.
You know, when I first started doing game music, it was a bunch of bleeps and bloops.
So the things about Terminator is that, keep in mind, you know, music before that was, you know, a lot of bleeps and bloops.
But there was one when I did the Terminator on Sega CD, and I was doing all that rock and guitar music, and people were hearing guitar and bass and drums, real guitar, bass, and drums in a video game for the first time. That was kind of like a shocking moment to a lot of people. And some people didn't like it. They're like, yeah, this doesn't sound like a video game. Where's the bleeps and bloops?
And so, you know, all the music back then was a lot of, you know, bleeps and bloops. And game audio back then and game music was considered like something that was like just a bonus thing that if we had time and energy and we'll put some crap in there at the end, you know. I was always the guy who was like, look, I want to be involved from the beginning. And why does it just have to be bleeps and bloops? And game audio back then and game music was considered like something that was like just a bonus thing that if we had time and energy and we'll put some crap in there at the end, you know?